which they play with this sharp infrared sensor. It's a sharp 2YO-A21 infrared distance sensor. Since this sensor is not very breadboard friendly, there's only those wires and this connector. Yep, can't get it off anymore. We're using this hookups. Comes a little arm out of it. Yep, grab it. And the next. And the last. This sensor transmits different voltages corresponding to the distance it measured. And that's why we need an analog input to read the data. We're using analog zero. There it is. It's using 5 volts and, like everything else, a ground. Before we start, we can look if we can make our life a little easier. Look under Sketch, Include Library, and open the Library Manager. If you filter for Sharp, we can see there is already a library for the Sharp IR sensor. So we install it. That was quick. And by including the library, there should be also an example delivered with it. Let's have a look. There it is. Sharp IR, get distance. So it seems pretty easy. You have the function called get distance and it delivers the distance in centimeters. Perfect. You only have to initialize the sensor with a pin and the model number. What we have here is the 2YO-A21. Not exactly the one you're looking for. But as we can see at the corresponding GitHub page, our sensor is also supported. So we copy that sensor name. Yeah, that seems to fit. And try to upload it. As we can see, it really measures distance. Although it's not quite accurate. The farther the object goes, the more errors we have. For example, now I have exactly a distance, the object to the sensor of 20 centimeters. That would be 22. Now we are at 30 and we can see there are many errors. That means this is not a very accurate sensor, but it's something. Well, compared to this ultrasonic sensor, this infrared sensor is quite inaccurate. From the datasheet, its most accuracy between 10 and 80 centimeters. I would rather say it's the most accuracy you get from 10 to 30 centimeters. But it has also advantages compared to this ultrasonic sensor. There are some surfaces this ultrasonic sensor doesn't get any reflections. While this sensor could probably get the wanted results. So if you're building one of those obstacle sensing robots, maybe you should combine an ultrasonic sensor and this infrared sensor. That's all. Bye.